To make a good summary of the text or book you are reading, it is possible, undoubtedly, by paying attention to some things. Abstract extraction, although it is an assignment/task given even to elementary school students, is actually an important task that requires using the brain's ability to analyze and synthesize. For this, we felt the need to prepare such an article for our friends who have problems extracting a summary or need advice to extract a better summary. The word abstract is defined as an article or a word that gives the meaning of an article or a word in a shorter and more concise form, hulasa, fezleke, ekspoze. If we look at the etymological structure of this word, we can say that it comes from the word essence. In other words, we can think of concise writing as the most concise form of writing. For this, the abstracts should be short, understandable and concise. You may be asked to summarize a 150-page novel, sometimes in one paragraph, sometimes in 3 pages. In such a situation, it is not at all difficult to outline the summary, as much as it takes ingenuity, as long as some principles are observed. Depending on the type and length of the text you are going to extract, the things you need to pay attention to may vary. But the simple reminders that we will list below will make it easier for you to make a summary of all kinds of texts. To make a good summary for this, you can start by following the steps listed below. Step-by-step summary extraction. 1. Read enough to understand the text. Understanding the text involves understanding the message given, beyond just reading and passing on the words. For this purpose, you should understand what is described from the beginning to the end of the text you are reading enough to stay in your mind. As it will be boring for you to summarize texts that you don't understand well, it also negatively affects the summary. 2. Save the important points. There are vital points in the text. This can be the most important scene of a novel or the concluding part of an article. Since these parts must necessarily be shown in the summary, you can underline the places that you consider important when reading, or use personal techniques that will make it noticeable. Not only by writing and drawing, but also by keeping it in mind, you can make a draft of the summary in your head. 3. Create an outline. Specify the scope, content, size, etc. of the summary. Make a sketch on a piece of scribble paper with all its aspects. This draft will give you a chance to correct your mistakes and complete your shortcomings. If you prepare a summary without drafting it, you may need to rewrite the summary to correct even the smallest deficiency. But the draft incident should not be exaggerated. Remember that in the end you will get a summary of one text.